entropy is generically regarded as a measure of disorder in physics and as a measure of information in communications. Entropy is calculated as the sum of P log P, where P are the frequencies of the n possible states of a variable. Entropy ranges between 0 and 1. When the variable assumes only one state, the entropy is 0. When the variable assumes any of the possible states with the same probability, then the entropy is 1. For datasets, the variable produces data points, and the states are the classes. So P are defined as the frequencies of the n possible classes in a dataset. For a dataset of 14 points, all in the plus or in the minus class, entropy is 0, that is, there is no information available. For a dataset of 14 points with 7 plus points and 7 minus points, entropy is 1, that is, there is a lot of information still available. Entropy describes the amount of information still available for discovery in the dataset. I once read a great example for this concept. Imagine two rooms full of kids singing. In one room, they all sing the same song, clean and ordered, no further information to dig up. In the other room, each kid sings a different song, total chaos, but a lot of information to dig up. That is what entropy measures, how many options are available in a system, however messed up. Entropy is used, for example, in the automatic construction of decision trees. Decision trees implement a tree-like structure to separate data in classes. They start with a root node containing all data and end with leaves assigning the class. Between the root and the leaves, we have a number of nodes implementing condition rules. Each data point travels from the root node to the leaf, following the path allowed by the conditions implemented in the nodes. Each node is associated with a data set. Each split is designed to create new data subsets, and each subset has a lower entropy than the original data set. The reduction of such entropy or similar other metrics is the goal of the algorithm that builds the decision tree.